In this video, we will set up JavaFX in Eclipse. Eclipse is very popular in Java programming, and actually it is my favorite. I find it to be faster, especially when running Java. So the first thing we'll do is go to the website and download JavaFX. openjx.io. The first index, when you go to download, the latest should be JavaFX 15, so it will redirect you to Java, to gloamhq.com/products/JavaFX. This way you'll get your JavaFX SDK. Navigate to the latest release date. You can see the latest release is 15.01. So whichever version you like, there is also early access builds for JavaFX 16. But I did download JavaFX 15 for this tutorial, but doesn't really matter. All of them should work the same way. So once you've downloaded, I've already downloaded mine. I'll just show you where I downloaded it to. It is in my download folder. This is it. Open JFX 15.01 Linux. So you'll be downloading a file that matches your operating system. So there's Windows, Mac, and Linux. So you choose one and make sure to download the SDK, not JMods, but SDK. So once you've done that, now fire up your IDE. You start mine. Started. So we want to create a JavaFX project. So what we do first is we create a Java project just the same way we normally do. So just you can use the shortcut, but just for demonstration, let me just use the user interface. So Java and Java project next. I'm giving it a name, tutorial JFX finish. Then create, go to source folder. I want you to create a main class. Go to create a main class. So that's the main class. I want you to write the JavaFX code that we will run to test that our library or our SDK has been installed correctly. So I have written my name, so we just copy. I'll just leave it in the description so that you can use it for testing also. So let me just copy it from here. So the ID is popping up errors because we have not loaded the library. So having downloaded the SDK, extracted and place it in a folder or in a location where you will easily remember or easily retrieve or access. So I placed mine in a folder called JavaLib. It is here, it already extracted JavaFX SDK, and then inside the SDK there are two folders, legal and lib. So we will be interested in the lib folder. This is where we will be working from. So let's go to our IDE, go to our project, right click and just to configure build path. Just configure build path and then class path, add external jars. So configure build path should take you to libraries, and from libraries just click class path and then add external jars. Navigate now to a lib folder inside the SDK and select all the jar files. So select all the jar files, open, and then apply, and then apply and close. Now the errors are gone, we are making good progress. The one thing remaining now is just to change the RAM configurations to modify accordingly. So we have to add JFX controls to the VM arguments. So go to RAM and then RAM configurations, and then go to the tab arguments, and then in the arguments tab it will be empty. So you just copy I'll leave the code to copy. It is --- module path, and then the path to the lib folder inside the SDK, and then --- add modules equal to JFX controls. So now looks like this. Just copy it and then paste it. It's the same. So we should click apply and then click run. Let's see if it works. If it works, yes it works. So thanks a lot for watching. Subscribe to my channel. I'll be also doing JavaFX in NetBeans. Thanks for watching, guys. See you guys.